Good morning. Can you hear me? Good morning. Good morning, one and all, and welcome to worship at Augustana Lutheran Church this morning. All of you who are regulars, welcome. All of you who are visitors, the parents, grandparents, aunts, uncles who are here for the program, welcome. We're delighted that you are all here, one and all. Just a couple announcements. There are plenty of announcements in your folder here that tell what's going on at Augustana in the coming week. This coming Wednesday, we have a worship service in the chapel beginning at 6:15. It's called a quieter Christmas worship. And you know, sometimes we get so caught up in the hustle and bustle. Anyone here of Christmas? Yeah, a few. And that it's nice to relax and to worship and to pray. And so this will be a quiet Christmas worship program on Wednesday, a worship service on Wednesday in the chapel at 6:15, and you're welcome. And then next Sunday is Christmas Eve. Can you believe it? Already, here we are. And there's four worship services, 11, 3, 5, and 7. And I encourage you to invite someone to come with you, a friend, a family member, a neighbor, an acquaintance, anyone. Just consider who God might be nudging you to invite them into one of the worship services next Sunday. And I have a challenge for you. I want you to pray for the coming Christmas Eve services. Please pray for your staff who's working hard. Pray for all the many volunteers that work to make these Christmas Eve services happen. Pray for the many people who will be attending. Pray for those who might be considering attending a worship service on Christmas Eve. So please just hold your church in prayer this coming week. And we look forward to celebrating with you today and in the coming week. As you're able, please stand and greet one another. You may remain standing. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who promises to draw near to us. Amen. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Everlasting God, you love justice, kindness, and humility. We confess the fear, greed, and self-absorption that makes us reluctant workers for your kingdom. We choose comfort over courage. We are careless with creation. Look upon us with mercy. Turn our hearts again to you. Make us glad to do your will and to walk in your ways for the sake of the world you love. Amen. In the tender compassion of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. God's covenant is eternal, and God's mercy rests upon us all. Amen.
Thank you. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. Stir up the wills of your faithful people, Lord God, and open our ears to the words of your prophets, that anointed by your Spirit, we may testify to your light. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Is it on? There you go, and just talk close.
Praise to you, O God, who holds our joy and sorrow. You bring water to parched ground and life out of death. Bless us as this light grows. It sends sorrow and sighing to flee away. Give us strength and patience, trusting that you are true to your promises. Transform the lives of all who suffer with your wonders near at hand. We pray in the name of Emmanuel, your promised child, God with us. Amen.
Amen.
The first reading is from the book of Isaiah, chapter 61. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord has anointed me. He has sent me to bring good news to the oppressed, to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and release to the prisoners, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn, to provide for those who mourn in Zion, to give them a garland instead of ashes, the oil of gladness instead of mourning, the mantle of praise instead of a faint spirit. They will be called oaks of righteousness, the planting of the Lord to display his glory. They shall build up the ancient ruins. They shall raise up the former devastations. They shall repair the ruined cities, the devastations of many generations. For I, the Lord, love justice. I hate robbery and wrongdoing. I will faithfully give them their recompense, and I will make an everlasting covenant with them. Their descendants shall be known among the nations, and their offspring among the peoples. All who see them shall acknowledge that they are a people whom the Lord has blessed. I will greatly rejoice in the Lord. My whole being shall exult in my God. For he has clothed me with the garments of salvation. He has covered me with the robe of righteousness. As a bridegroom decks himself with a garland, and as a bride adorns herself with her jewels. For as the earth brings forth its shoots, and as a garden causes what is sown in it to spring up, so the Lord God will cause righteousness and praise to spring up before all the nations. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The second reading is from the book of 1 Thessalonians, chapter 5. Rejoice always, pray without ceasing, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. Do not quench the spirit, do not despise the words of prophets, but test everything, hold fast to what is good, abstain from every form of evil. May the God of peace himself sanctify you entirely, and may your spirit and soul and body be kept sound and blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The one who calls you is faithful, and he will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Children this morning for they will offer the sermon. They're given the sermon today, and we're excited about that. The Holy Gospel according to John, the first chapter. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. This is the testimony given by John when the Jews sent priests and Levites from Jerusalem to ask him, "Who are you?" He confessed and did not deny it, but confessed, "I am not the Messiah." And they asked him, "What then? Are you Elijah?" He said, "I am not." "Are you the prophet?" He answered, "No." Then they said to him, "Who are you? Let us have an answer for those who sent us. What do you say about yourself?" He said, "I am the voice of one crying out in the wilderness, 'Make straight the way of the Lord.' As the prophet Isaiah said, Now they had been sent from the Pharisees. They asked him, "Why then are you baptizing if you are neither the Messiah, nor Elijah, nor the prophet?" John answered them, "I baptize with water. Among you stands one whom you do not know, the one who is coming after me. I am not worthy to untie the thong of his sandal." This took place in Bethany across the Jordan, where John was baptizing. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
A long time ago,
engaged to a man named Joseph who lived there too. One day, an angel from God came and talked to Mary. He told Mary she was going to have a baby.
"Mary, you are going to have a baby, and he will be the Son of God."
"Oh, okay."
Angel left. Now, Joseph wasn't sure what he was going to do when he heard that Mary was going to have a baby.
So one night while he was asleep, the angel came to talk to him.
"Joseph, Mary is going to have a baby from God. It's okay for you to marry her and take care of her and the baby. You will name the baby Jesus."
"Oh, okay." And so that's just what he did.
Thank you.
later, the Emperor of Rome, Caesar Augustus, said that everyone had to go to their hometown to be counted.
Everyone, go back to your hometown so that I can count you.
Mary and Joseph went to the town of Bethlehem to be counted because Bethlehem was known as the city of David and Joseph was of the house and line of David.
There were so many people, in fact, that there was no room for them in the inn. So Mary and Joseph stayed in a stable, which was a place for animals to stay warm and dry.
There was a horse there.
Me.
There was a tiger there.
There was a rabbit there.
Mary and Joseph stayed there too.
While they were there, baby Jesus was born, and Mary wrapped him up warm and laid him in the manger.
Out in the fields watching over their flocks of sheep.
The angels came and talked to the shepherds. Terribly afraid.
Don't be afraid. I bring you good news. The Savior, which is Christ the Lord, has been born today in Bethlehem. You will find the baby wrapped in soft cloths and lying in a manger.
And all of a sudden, there were lots of angels saying,
Glory to God in the highest! Peace on earth!
Left. When the angels had left, the shepherds went and found the baby Jesus in the manger, just as they had been told. When they found him, they worshipped him.
Not far away in a place called Jerusalem, there lived an evil king named Herod. A couple months after baby Jesus was born, three wise men came to Jerusalem looking for the newly born king of the Jews.
Where is he who was born the king of the Jews? Where is the king of the Jews?
In Bethlehem.
Go find him and tell me where he is, so I can worship him too.
King Herod
didn't really want to worship baby Jesus. He wanted to harm him. The wise men were warned by God about this, so they went home another way.
When the king found out he was tricked, he was really mad.
Hard! I'm really mad!
He was determined to destroy this newborn king. So, King Herod sent his soldiers to Bethlehem to find the baby Jesus.
Go and find him and destroy him.
But God warned Joseph in a dream to get out of there.
So they did.
Mary and Joseph and the little baby Jesus went to Egypt. They stayed there until the evil King Herod died.
Joseph and baby Jesus came back from Egypt. They went to live in the town of Nazareth again.
Hey, you can come back now. It's safe.
Mary and Joseph and baby Jesus came back from Egypt. They went to live in the town of Nazareth again.
And that's where the baby Jesus grew. And now you've heard it all.
About how God sent his only son to be born as a baby so that later he could save everyone from their sins. And all it took was
just a little Christmas. Glory to God in the highest. Peace on earth. Good
done, children. We are so proud of you. What a great message. And I love the promise. Oh, okay. When God asks us, that's all we need to say. Okay. Great job. Thank you. invite you to stand, remain standing, as we confess our faith to the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
God of light and peace, we stand before your altar to offer our prayers for the church, for the world, for those in need, and for all gathered in this community. God of light and peace, help us to remember that for your church, this is the season of watching and listening. May we hear and heed the voice of John crying in the wilderness, be alert for the coming of the bridegroom, and listen for the watchman's cry. Refresh and reinvigorate your church as it moves into a new year. Merciful God, God of light and peace, infuse us with hope and confidence so that we may carry your light to a struggling and war-torn world. We pray for all the needs of the world, for peace and goodwill over the earth, and that your whole creation may know the promise of this season. Merciful God, God of light and peace, we remember the poor and the helpless, the cold, the hungry, and the oppressed, the sick in body and mind, and those who mourn, the lonely and the unloved, the aged and the little children. Help us remember that our hands do your work so that we may be bearers of your light and comfort. Merciful God, God of light and peace, we thank you for all the blessings of these days in our place. Music, celebrations, fellowship, and the children's pageant. Hear our prayers for those in need of hope and healing. Jean, Sandy, Benita, Kathy, Dolly, Katie, Gregory, Ursula, Cindy, Diane. And we ask for your consolation of the family and friends of those who have died. Bev Garvin, Don Pace, Jared Vandervliet, Noah Holman Ferris. And we rejoice with the Scholes family in the birth of Logan Thomas. Merciful God, God of light and peace, into your hands we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy and rejoicing in your Advent promise. Through Jesus Christ, our coming Savior. Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you always. Please take a moment to share a sign of peace with those around you.
Thank you.
Holy One, by your merciful hand, abundance springs up from the earth. Receive and bless these gifts. Let them be a sign of your steadfast love and faithfulness for all people. Through Jesus Emmanuel, God with us. Amen. The Lord be with you. Give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God. Through our Savior Jesus Christ, you comforted your people with the promise of the Redeemer, through whom you will also make all things new. In the day when he comes to judge the world in righteousness. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven. We praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy One, the beginning and the end, the giver of life, blessed are you for the birth of creation. Blessed are you in the darkness and in the light. Blessed are you for your promise to your people. Blessed are you in the prophet's hopes and dreams. Blessed are you for Mary's openness to your will. Blessed are you for your Son, Jesus, the Word made flesh. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, Jesus took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Holy God, we long for your Spirit. May your word take flesh in us, fill us with your light, bring the gift of peace on earth. All praise and glory are yours, holy light in the darkness, word of God incarnate, peace that passes all understanding, one God, now and forever. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. You may be seated. This is Christ's table, and Christ died and rose for all people. You are here in worship, either on live stream or here in the sanctuary, and you are welcome to Holy Communion. On live stream, we invite you to have bread or cracker and wine or juice, and to receive them with these words: the body of Christ given for you, and the blood of Christ shed for you. Here in the sanctuary, the ushers will direct you forward while you receive a piece of bread. It's all gluten-free. And then next, you'll choose either wine or grape juice. Grape juice is light-colored. And the little cups will go on the altar rail in the basket as you move your way back to your seat. If for reasons of your own, you would rather receive a blessing instead of communion, you may cross your arms when you come forward and we'll know to give you a blessing. And now we sing the Lamb of God together.
Oh, my God.
Please stand as you're able. May the body and blood of Jesus Christ our Lord strengthen you and keep you in God's grace. Amen. Generous God, in bread and cup you have revealed your glory. Nourished by this meal, send us out to proclaim your good news of liberation and hope, brought to birth in Jesus Christ, Emmanuel. Amen. The God of peace bless you, the love of Christ comfort you, and the power of the Spirit sustain you now and forever. Amen. Amen.